Well, good morning, Miramar, and welcome to the show. I'm your host, Tamara G. Don't forget, you can check us out on all of our social media. We're on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram at City of Miramar. That's M-I-R-A-M-A-R. And with me is Dr. Julie Gatza. She is the co-founder of the Florida Wellness Institute, and she is one of the nation's top chiropractic physicians with more than 30 years of clinical practice. She also regularly lectures and educates audiences on how to maintain optimum health with a focus on healthy, balanced, parasite-free eating. So that's a good thing. And we're going to be talking this morning about candida control, because obviously that is something that a lot of people are having problems with and may not even know that they are having that problem. So welcome to the show, Dr. Julie.
Thank you, Tamara. Nice to be here.
And so happy to have you. So let's talk a little bit about, first of all, what is candida albicans? A lot of people probably don't even know they have it because they can't pronounce it.
Well, that's true. Candida albicans is actually a naturally occurring yeast in your digestive system, and it keeps in balance with the good bacteria in your body. So everyone has it. Everyone should have it under control. What occurs is we've all been on antibiotics at least once, and antibiotics don't just wipe out your ear infection, your throat infection, your lung infection. It wipes out all the bacteria. It doesn't just go into wiping out the ear bacteria. So what occurs then is you've wiped out this good bacteria, which should keep the yeast in good control. When there's no gatekeeper, the yeast are like a whole bunch of kids at a concert. The gate's been open. They flood in, they go crazy, and yeasts survive with sugar. So many of us have unwanted sugar cravings. We can't get a control on it. We think we have no more willpower. And we're not just talking obvious sugars. We're talking also carbohydrates. So breads and pretzels and pastas and pizzas and all these things are also foods that turn into sugar and they feed yeast. So this is one of the things that you're not aware of that yeast is causing. And it looks like you just have no willpower, or you're just, you know, a fat, lazy American and you can't get your weight under control, or all the other symptoms that aren't so obvious if you have a yeast situation.
Well, now I know also, Dr. Julie, that with women, when we take antibiotics, we have definitely a problem with yeast, because immediately when they give you the antibiotic, they give you the prescription for the yeast infection that is pretty much going to happen. Is this the reason why, what you just described, that the antibiotic basically kills all of the bacteria?
Yes, it does. And it does disrupt hormonal balance too. So you've got all sorts of things happening in the body that should be always in a maintained balance. And when it's not, what occurs is something gets imbalanced. So you can have women's hormones going up and down and up and down. You can have, all sorts of things that can go along with this: fatigue and bloating and gas and you know, bad periods and infertility and all these things, because the hormonal situation is also now altered because you've got this gut situation.
Well, let's talk a little bit about that, because you just mentioned some of them, but what are some physical symptoms that often accompany an overload of candida in the body? Would you know that you have it?
It's hard to necessarily pinpoint, because it looks like something else. Mm-hmm. And there's not one test that you can say, oh, great, we've got this, you know, overgrowth of yeast. If there was, it would be a heck of a lot easier. So you really go by somebody's history and you go by their symptoms. One, have they been on antibiotics? Have they had a surgery? Have they been on some medication that might be disrupting the gut? Are they under tremendous stress? Okay, good. So that's sort of the history. Now let's look at symptoms. They can have urinary tract infections. They can have obvious vaginal yeast infections. The guys can have, you know, jock itch. They can have toenail fungus. Those are kind of the obvious. Then you can have fatigue, brain fog, digestive upset, hormonal imbalance, itchy skin where you just can't itch deep enough no matter how many creams you use. And all these can mimic other things, but the underlying aspect could be the yeast that's sitting there that our diets are disrupting, our way that we eat our food and process our food and are growing our food. I mean, technology has improved so much, but our bodies are the same bodies that they were 2,000 years ago. So our grandparents were raised with the correct forms of eating. the home cooked meal, the getting things from the ground, and you know,
vegetables always. Yes,
it was always you know, the perimeter of the grocery store, and nothing was altered. So now I have a lot of elderly whom have slid into this American way of eating, which is fast and easy, and you can rip open a package, a box, a can. There's tons of sugar in it. There's fillers. There's this. There's tons of fats. There's not a bunch of nutrition. And now we have all this elderly having health problems. And we're raising our kids, not even how they were raised. So what are their kids' generation now going to look like when they're older? Because they didn't even get the benefit of how our grandparents and even myself was raised.
Right. And I was going to say the same here. I grew up in the country. My grandmother had a garden. My great grandfather had a garden, my grandmother, and we had a garden. I have shelled enough peas and enough greens in my lifetime that I don't ever have to do that again.
That's right.
But I get what you're saying. And so everything that you just mentioned, you're right. That could mimic something else. But it could be as simple as truly getting rid of the excess candida in your body. Why is that not what some doctors, because I can know you can't speak for everybody, but just to start with the basic stuff before you start putting me on medicines that may or not be the reason why, you know, I feel bad.
Well, it's a two-point answer for that. If you take, I'm a chiropractor, so I elected to be a doctor, same education as an MD, without having drugs and surgery as my solutions. I always knew I could refer it out, and I've done that a number of times in my 31 years. But if you take two students, chiropractors, naturopaths, and MD students, they all want to help. So you put a chiropractor down through at the end of school system, at the end of the hallway is drugs and surgery. But in the meantime, we get to kick open a ton of doors. We get to kick open homeopathy and supplementation and applied kinesiology and cranial therapy, all these different things that actually can contribute to how to treat a body without drugs and surgery. The medical students get to the end of the hallway, and that is their solutions. There isn't solutions for opening up those doors and, you know, trying to find out what else is there. It's one sort of path. So it's not that they didn't want it. They weren't educated. You have to be an exceptionally interested medical doctor to break through that system and want to find out some of the things that you weren't taught in school. So with that, you know, the way to actually handle a yeast overgrowth, I used to put a bubble over my practice because it was such a pain. It was hard on the patients. It was hard on the doctor. It took 6 months to 2 years to get under control. And about 5 years ago, I found out about this product that's a plant that's only grown in New Zealand, and it wipes out yeast overgrowth in 30 days.
Wow. Okay, so we're going to talk about that in just a minute. If you're just tuning in, we're speaking with Dr. Julie Gatza. She is the co-founder of the Florida Wellness Institute, also one of the nation's top chiropractic physicians, been in practice more than 30 years. And we're talking today about candida and how to get rid of it out of your bodies, because if you're just tuning in, Dr. Julie has said that it is kind of like the root of a lot of the problems that people have, which is an overgrowth of candida in their body. So tell us about this plant and how it can get rid of candida, and how do we get it?
Sure. So it only grows in New Zealand, and I had never heard of it. It's called the Horopito plant. And so what they've done is they've captured it, put it in a capsule, and you take one a day. And in 30 days, you've basically wiped out the excessive overgrowth of yeast. It still keeps some of the colonies, but it wipes out the excessive. So I end up treating a lot of people that come to Florida from all over the world. And two New Zealanders about 3 months ago, I was mentioning this, and they said, oh yeah, Horopito. And like, it's a common term in New Zealand on something that they've used. And they said, oh no, everyone knows about that. It's used for way more than just yeast. It's like the healing herb that only is grown in New Zealand. So with that, I was like, oh, how cool. We haven't heard about this. But when I came across this Colorex, which is the Horopito then put into a product, K-O-L-O-R-E-X, mm-hmm. You take one capsule a day, and you do have to clean up your diet, knock out the sugars and the excess of carbohydrates, because you don't want to keep feeding yeast while you're trying to kill the yeast. So you do want to, for 30 days, put your diet into a heavier protein, heavier vegetable, not salads, steamed green vegetables, and lots of water. And you can often have a bit of a yeast die-off, which happens in the first 3 to 4 days, where you might be a little fatigued, a little headachy, a little less than great. But as the yeast is dying, you can experience these symptoms of the toxins going through the system. It's nothing that puts you on the couch. It's just be aware that that does occur within the first 3 to 4 days.
Yes, with any other type of detox. Mm-hmm. Walk us through the 4 steps for reducing candida overload then.
Okay, so one of the first things that you want to do is you want to knock out your sugars. They're carbohydrates. You want to eat more protein, more vegetables, keep your fruit to a minimum. And as far as what you consume in liquids, coffee, tea, pop, carbonation, they change how you absorb. So if you can start to wean yourself off of those and just drink plain old water. If you need to flavor your water with some lemon, some mint, some lime, some cucumbers, that is totally fine naturally. And that's just the first start. I pretty much have any patient that comes to me with any problem start right there. Okay. Number two,
sugar-free diet is what you're saying.
Sugar-free and carbohydrate-free diet, lots of proteins, lots of vegetables, don't skip a meal, and tons of water. Number two, you want to recolonate your digestive system with the Colorex, because I don't know anything else that actually, sorry, not recolonate, but kill the yeast colonies with the Colorex. It's so much easier to lose weight when you don't have something screaming for sugar. It's way easier to have your skin look better and not be itchy and not have fatigue when you don't have yeast screaming for sugar and taking up a lot of your energy that should be given to you throughout the day. And then you want to also get yourself on a good probiotic. The same company that sells the Colorex does sell an awesome enzyme with probiotics in it, so we can give them that information. But those are the first few steps on this. And then you want to definitely boost your liver function. And boosting your liver function, yes, you can take things like milk thistle and you can do these other herbal things. But the way that I've seen how to boost your liver is to clean up your diet. And that way you can start to absorb nutrition from your actual diet. Coffee, tea, pop, carbonation keep you from absorbing nutrition. The only way the liver will work is if it gets nutrition at a cellular level to make it go, oh yeah, my job out of 500 of them, number one is to detoxify and the other one is to run your metabolism. Lo and behold, when you get rid of the things that keep you from absorbing and only drink water, you'd be amazed that within a 5 to 10 day period of time, you have less circles under the eyes, your face looks brighter, you're not so bloated, you feel better. And so those are the 4 steps that I sort of handle with every person that comes in, because it never will hurt to fix those things. And then we can focus on whatever else if it's still hanging about.
And it seems so simple, Dr. Julie. I mean, drink water, get rid of, or, you know, definitely decrease as much as you can the sugars in all forms. But it's also very hard because you mentioned earlier about how we eat today as Americans. Everything is convenient. Everything is, let me just pick it up and, you know, I can warm it up in the microwave or I can just take it off the shelf and eat it. How do we look for those things that maybe we don't even know have sugars in them that we're eating every day?
Let's just make it easy. Shop on the perimeter of the grocery store. If you don't understand what an ingredient is in it, you shouldn't be eating it. So that means, you know, broccoli, chicken, fish, carrots, celery, all the fruits, all the vegetables, all the meats, the seafood, all of this is on the outside of the grocery store. And that's where we start. So don't skip breakfast. The other thing is many people grab a cup of coffee, send their kids on the way to school with a bowl of cereal and maybe a bagel and they're off. And now you're expecting your kid to pay attention, to get along with others, to be alert, to be able to absorb information. And you basically just fed them a bunch of carbohydrates and expecting miracles. They need bacon, they need eggs, they need sausage, they need leftover dinner from last night. They don't need to eat an American breakfast. They need protein, protein, protein. I am a fan of eggs in every form it can come. And the other thing is people who skip breakfast are usually the people who sit on the couch at night and want to eat sugars and cookies and have the popcorn and sit in front of the TV. Almost one for one, breakfast skippers are late night eaters.
Wow. See, the things that you learn. If you are just tuning in to Good Morning Miramar, welcome to the show. I'm Tamara G, your host. And we have with us Dr. Julie Gatza. She is the co-founder of the Florida Wellness Institute, also a licensed top chiropractic physician, more than 30 years of clinical practice. And she also talks about how each patient, it has the ability and their body can heal itself if we know what we're doing. We're talking about candida today. I have had some blood tests done and I know that I have definitely an overflux of candida. So I was taking something as well. You also have a product that you have been giving to your patients. Tell us again about that product.
So this product is called Colorex, K-O-L-O-R-E-X. And it's basically encapsulated herb, horopito herb from New Zealand. You take one a day for 30 days, it's done. You do not have to stay on it. Now, if you've been on antibiotics and you've wiped out all your bacteria, you want to have one in the medicine cabinet to start again. If you've had a stressful bit of time where you've been eating and drinking a little off the, rails, okay, fine. Start again. If you're trying to start a diet or you're itchy or you don't have the energy you need or you're gassy and bloated, start it. You can do it at any time. And this is also okay for children. But it's just such a nice, easy start you up so that you're at least handling a situation that is really tough to address if you don't know where it's coming from. I have a relative who is having chronic urinary tract infections, and we were pulling our hair out trying to figure out why. And finally, I realized that she had had a yeast overgrowth. We cleaned up the diet. She was drinking too much carbonation. We took the carbonation out. We put the Colorex in. And every 5 weeks that she was getting urinary tract infections and going crazy trying to figure out what to take at the drugstore, it pretty much stopped. And it was because of this carbonation. She was upsetting the digestive system. She was craving sugars and trying to keep her diet in, but it was, getting hard for her. And we put her on the Colorex and no more urinary tract infections.
And when you mentioned the carbonation, are you saying like the Cokes, the Pepsis, Dr. Peppers, things like
even that? Even Perrier, even the carbonated water.
Wow. Yeah.
What it does is if you take a piece of steak and you put it in a glass of soapy water, the next morning, it looks like a piece of steak in a glass of soapy water. That's what coffee, teas, pops, and carbonation does. When you take a piece of steak and you put it in vinegar, that vinegar and the steak look really ugly the next morning. That is how your digestive system should be working. So we all want acidic digestive systems, but doing those other things change it to more of a basic or alkaline, and that's the steak and soapy water situation. So your body is starving. I find anyone who's suffering with a weight problem and pretty much with a chronic health problem, they are starving. They're eating food that they can't absorb. They've got this disruption going on in the digestive system. And so the food's going in and it's not getting into them cellularly. So they are starving at a cellular level.
Another thing too, that you mentioned earlier, Dr. Julie, was about probiotics. All of a sudden in the last, I would probably say maybe 10, 15 years, we are hearing so much about probiotics. Never had heard of them before. And now they're everywhere.
Right. So probiotics basically reestablish the good bacteria in your gut. And the antibiotics wipe that out. Stress will do the same. Poor eating. So there are lots of different places to get probiotics. And yes, you can get them from yogurt, but I don't think it's an adequate amount when you're really trying to make this work again. Mm-hmm. So there's a company, I'm a sponsor for this company because we meld so well. I love their products and I know what to talk about for them because I love what they do and I use them constantly. Mm-hmm. So they have another product called Absorbaid, which is a digestive enzyme, and they have Absorbaid Platinum, which has all the enzymes to break down your food. Plus it has probiotics to help put back in this good bacteria. So if you're on 30 days of the Colorex and then you want to put yourself on the Absorbaid to break down your meal, it wrings more nutrition from each one of your meals, and then you got probiotics. So yes, some of this sort of goes in waves as far as, all of a sudden at one point in the past, fish oil, everyone knows about because somebody picked it up on a news and so did the magazines, and vitamin E is not good for you and vitamin C is this. And that information has always been there. And yes, vitamin E is good for you. And all these things are correct, but because somebody picked it up and then others start to talk about it, or patients approach their doctors and the doctors have to scramble to know what they're talking about. You do need a balance, and it always must start with the gut. And if you start with the gut, you will pretty much ensure you have the ability to have your health back. But if you don't fix what's happening at the intestinal and the gut level, it's really like going uphill with roller skates on.
Wow. All right. So tell us, how can people get more information, or if they wanted to reach you, Dr. Julie, at the Florida Wellness Institute, and to find out more information about the products that you are talking about, the Colorex brand?
Good. They can get onto the website, which is naturessources.com. They can read about the Colorex, the Absorbaid Platinum. They can read about this. I always encourage to do your research, because once you understand it, you own it. Now you have a leg to stand on, and somebody is not just pushing something at you or trying to sell something to you. You must really own it, which is why I spend time to educate. And I love being on the radio, because I get to speak to more than one person about stuff that they should understand. Mm-hmm. They can also go to the 1-800 number, and if they use the code radio, they can get 20% off their first order. And that phone number is 1-800-827-7656. And, you know, don't be shy about this. Definitely do this. You won't know until you try it. You can be a consumer of information and, you know, sitting on your toadstool, never doing anything. The only person that will ever help you is you in this area. No one's knocking on your door and saying, hey, today's the day, we're going to make sure you get Colorex and, you know, change your diet. So knock on your own door and get off your toadstool and make a motion to actually get yourself healthy and take responsibility for it, because you're the one that's going to benefit from it in the end.
Absolutely. 1-800-827-7656. 1-800-827-7656. Thank you so very much, Dr. Julie Gatza. She is the co-founder of the Florida Wellness Institute. And if you want more information or how to reach her, you can look her up as well. But definitely Nature's Source to check out the Colorex brand of Candida control supplements and topical creams, and the Florida Wellness Institute for Dr. Julie Gatza. Thank you so much for being with us today on Good Morning Miramar. We certainly appreciate it, and thank you very much.
Thank you, Tamara.
And until next time, I'm Tamara G. See ya.